Good morning, children, and welcome back to the digital classroom of Vikram Juneja. In my previous video, I had done the line-by-line explanation of Act 2, Scene 1, and a part of Act 2, Scene 2 was discussed. In today's video, we are going to continue with Act 2, Scene 2. We will also cover Act 2, Scene 3 and Act 2, Scene 4 of The Merchant of Venice. As we already know that Lancelot has already decided that he would not work under Shylock anymore. So he takes his father Gobbo to his new master Bassanio. Enter Bassanio with Leonardo and other followers or two. Bassanio speaks to his followers. You may do so, but let it be so hasted that supper be ready at the farthest by 5 o'clock of the clock. See these letters delivered. Put the liveries to making and desire Graciano to come and into my lodging. So Bassanio is speaking to his attendant. He is talking to his attendant and getting ready for Belmont. He says, all right, go ahead, but do everything quickly. Supper must be ready at 5 at least at the latest. Make sure these letters get delivered. He has got some letters which have to be delivered. Get the uniforms made and tell Graciano to come visit me soon. Exit the follower. Lancelot comes. He says to him, father. Lancelot says, go talk to him, father. Gobbo says to Bassanio, God bless your worship. Sir, God bless you. Bassanio replies, Grimercy, wouldst thou have thou aught with me? Bassanio says, thank you. What do you want with me? Gobbo says, here is my son, sir, a poor boy. Gobbo replies, this is my son, sir. He is a poor boy. To which Lancelot intervenes in saying, not a poor boy, sir, but the rich Jew's man that would, sir, as my father shall specify. So Lancelot intervenes between his father's conversation with the Bassanio. He says, not a poor boy, but the rich Jew's servant who wants as my father will explain. Gobbo says, he hath a great infection, sir, as one would say to sir. So Gobbo also has this uncanny knack of inverting the words like his son, Lancelot. He says, he wants very much, sir, as one might say, to work for. So he wanted to say affection and he spoke out the word infection. Lancelot intervenes once again. He says, indeed, the short and the long is, I serve the Jew and have a desire as my father shall specify. Lancelot says, to put it briefly, I work for the Jew and I want as my father will tell you. To which Gobbo says, his master and he, saving your worship's reverence, are scarce gator cousins. Gobbo says, he and his master aren't exactly friends. To which Lancelot says, to be brief, the very truth is that the Jew, having done me wrong, doth cause me as my father being, I hope, an old man shall fructify unto you. Lancelot says, to be brief, sir, the truth is that the Jew has done me wrong and that forces me to, as my father, an old man, will inform you. Gobbo says, I have here a dish of doves that I would bestow upon your worship as my suit is. He says, I have a present I would like to give you, sir, and I want to request that. And then Lancelot intervenes once again. In very brief, the suit is impertinent to myself, as your worship shall know by the honest old man, and though I say it, thou old man, yet poor man, my father. So Lancelot again inverts the word. He wanted to say pertinent means relevant. He says impertinent. He says, to make a long story short, sir, the request is about me, as this good old man will tell you, even though I'm his son and I'm the one saying it, this old man is the poor man, a poor man who is going to speak out to you. Bassanio says, one speak for both. What would you? Bassanio gets irritated by that. He says, one of you do the talking. What do you want? Lancelot says, he comes to the point. He says, serve you, sir, to work for you, sir. So Lancelot, having spoken that, I want to work for you, sir, Gobbo says, that's the very defect of the matter, sir. Again, inverted the word. He wanted to say that's the very effect of the matter. Gobbo is replying, that's what we are trying to say, sir. Bassanio says, I know thee well. Thou hast obtained thy suit. Shylock, thy master, spoke with me this day and hath preferred thee it if it be preferment to leave a rich Jew servant to become the follower of so poor a gentleman. Bassanio replies, I know who you are, Lancelot. You can have what you want. I spoke with your master, Shylock, today, and he recommended you to me. If you want to leave a rich Jew to work for a poor gentleman, you're welcome too. Lancelot says, the old proverb is very well parted between my master, Shylock, and you, sir. You have the grace of God, sir, and he hath enough. Lancelot replies, do you know the old proverb, sir? The grace of God is enough, sir. It could be divided between you and my boss, Shylock. You have the grace of God, and he might be having enough. Bassanio says, thou speakest it well. Go farther with thy son. Take leave of thy old master and inquire my lodging out. Bassanio says, nicely put words, Lancelot. Go with your son, old man. And then he turns to the old man and says that you shall go with your son. Say goodbye to your old master, Lancelot, and find your way to my house. Then Bassanio turns to his attendants. He says, give him a livery more guarded than his fellows. See it done. So Bassanio says to his attendants, he says, give him a uniform that's a little nicer than the others. Make sure it gets done quickly. To which Lancelot says, father, and I cannot get a service, no, I have never a tongue in my head, reading his own palm. Well, if any man in Italy have a fairer table which doth offer to swear upon a book, I shall have good fortune. Lancelot cannot believe his fortune. He says, father, go ahead. I can't get a job, can I? He cannot believe himself. I can't talk well, no. Reading his own palm, he says, if any man in Italy has a palm good enough to swear on a Bible with, it's me. I have got very good luck. Go to, here's a simple line of life. Here is a small trifle of wives. Alas, 15 wives is nothing. 11 widows and 9 maids is a simple coming in for a man. And then to escape drowning thrice and to be in the peril of life with the edge of a feather bed. Here are simple escapes. So Lancelot further says, here is my lifeline. It shows a few wives. 15 wives is nothing. 11 widows and 9 maids is a humble beginning for a one man. It seems I'll almost drown 3 times and my life will be in danger when I'm caught in bed with another man's wife. But these little lines are escape routes I can take to get out of that one. Well, if fortune be a woman, he says, she is a good wrench for this gear. Father, come, I'll take my leave of the Jew in the twinkling. So he says, but these little lines are escape routes, he says. And then he says, if luck is a lady, she is good at this business. Father, let's go. I will leave the Jew behind in the blink of an eye. Exit Lancelot the clown with old Gobbo. Lancelot and Gobbo exit. Scene. Bassanio says, I pray thee, good Leonardo, think on this, these things being bought and orderly bestowed, return in haste, for I do feast tonight, my best esteemed acquaintance, hie thee go. So Bassanio says to Leonardo, one of his servants, he says, please Leonardo, think about this. He hands him a piece of paper. These things have been bought and are ready. Hurry back here. I'm having dinner tonight with someone I greatly respect. Go now. Leonardo says, my best endeavors shall be done herein. Leonardo replies, I'll do my best, sir. Enter Gratiano. Gratiano to Leonardo, where is your master? Gratiano speaks to Leonardo, where your master is? To which Leonardo replies, yonder, sir, he walks. So he says, he is walking over there, sir. And after saying this, Leonardo exits the scene. To which Gratiano reaches out to Bassanio. He says, Signor Bassanio, that is Mr. Bassanio. Bassanio says, Gratiano. Gratiano replies, I have a suit to you. Means, I have a favor to ask. I have a request for you. Bassanio replies, you have obtained it. Bassanio says, anything for you. You have got your request before you ask for it. Gratiano says, you must not deny me. I must go with you to Belmont. Gratiano speaks, do not say no, let me go with you to Belmont. To which Bassanio says, why then you must, but hear thee, Gratiano, thou art too wild, too rude, and bold of voice. Part that become thee happily enough, and in such eyes as appears not false. Bethany says, well, if you have to go, you have to go. But listen to me, Graciano. Sometimes you get a bit too wild and you let your voice get a bit loud and rude. These things look good on you, of course, and to the people like you and me. There's nothing wrong with it. Means as far as we are concerned, we do not find anything wrong with it. But where thou art not known, why there they show something too liberal. Pray thee, take pain to allay with some cold drops of modesty, the skipping spirit, lest through thy wild behavior I be misconstrued in the place I go to and lose my hopes. So he's saying, but in places where people don't know you, your behavior might seem too wild. Please try to act a little more serious, or the people in Belmont will get the wrong impression about me and your wildness will make me blow my chance with Portia. To which Graciano says, Signor Bassanio, hear me. If I do not put on a sober habit, talk with respect and swear but now and then, wear prayer books in my pocket, look demurely, nay more, while grace is saying, hood mine eyes, thus with my hat and sigh and say amen. So Graciano actually is trying to actually tell Bassanio that, listen, Bassanio, there is nothing to worry about. I'll be solemn looking. I'll talk with respect and I'll only swear once in a while. I will carry prayer books in my pocket, he says, and look sweet even more. Okay. So he says, while grace is saying, hood mine eyes thus with my hat and sigh and say amen. Use all observance or civility, like one well-studied in a sad ostent to please his grandam. Never trust me more. He says, while grace is being said, I will be modest and say amen. I'll watch my manners as if I'm trying to please my grandma. If I don't do all this, never trust me again. Bassanio says, well, we shall see you bearing. So Bassanio says, well, we shall see how you act. Graciano says, nay, but I bar tonight, you shall not gouge me by what we do tonight. Graciano says, okay, but please spare me for tonight. Do not gouge me tonight. Tonight doesn't count. Do not count tonight. You cannot judge me based on what I do tonight because we are feasting and I would keep my behavior like that for tonight at least. Bassanio says, no, that were pity. I would entreat you rather to put on your boldest suit of mirth, for we have friends that purpose merriment. But fare you well, I have some business. Bassanio says, no, it would be a shame for you to act serious tonight. I would rather see you having fun, because we have friends coming who want to have fun. Anyway, I have to say goodbye to you, he says. Now, I have got some business to take care of. Graciano says, and I must to Lorenzo and the rest, but we will visit you at the supper time. Graciano says, I also have to join Lorenzo and the others, but we will surely visit you at the supper time. And then Graciano and Bassanio exit. This was with regard to Act 2, Scene 2. Now we are going to begin with Act 2, Scene 3. This particular scene takes place in Venice, where Jessica, the daughter of Shylock, and Lancelot are in conversation with each other. Now, enter Jessica and Lancelot the clown. Jessica says, I'm sorry thou wilt leave my father, so our house is hell and thou a merry devil. So what Jessica is trying to say to Lancelot is that, I'm sorry you're leaving my father like this. It's hell in our house and you help cheer it up like a funny devil. So she further says, and this thou robe it of some taste of tediousness, but fare thee well, there is a ducat for thee. So she says that you take away all the sadness from the house and you are a funny devil and you cheer up the entire house with your presence. But goodbye. Then she gives a ducat. She says, here's a ducat for you. You shall take this. And Lancelot, soon at supper shalt thou see Lorenzo, who is my new master's guest. Give him this letter. And she gives a letter to Lancelot. She says, here's a ducat for you, and for this you have to do me a work. You'll soon be meeting Lorenzo. Now Lorenzo is a friend of Antonio. He is in love with Jessica. So she says that you will soon be meeting Lorenzo at supper. He'll be a guest of your new master, that is Bassanio. Give him this letter. And then she gives letter to Lancelot and she says, do it secretly. Okay. She says, give him this letter and so farewell. I would not have my father see me and talk with thee. So I do not want my father to see me talking to you. Goodbye to you. Take this letter to Lorenzo. Hand it over to him. Okay. Lancelot says, adieu. Tears exhibit my tongue, most beautiful pagan. Most sweet Jew, if a Christian do not play the knave and get thee, I am much deceived. But adieu. These foolish drops do something drown my manly spirit. Adieu. So Lancelot says goodbye, final goodbye to Jessica. He says, goodbye, Jessica. My tears show you my feelings, my beautiful pagan, my sweet Jew. I am sure some Christian will resort to trickery to get you. But goodbye. It is not manly to cry, so I would not cry goodbye to you. Okay, Jessica says, farewell, good Lancelot. Goodbye to you, Lancelot. Lancelot exits the scene. Alack, Jessica speaks a soliloquy here. She says, alack, what heinous sin is it in me to be ashamed to be my father's child? But though I am a daughter to his blood, I am not to his manners. O Lorenzo, if thou keep promise, I shall end this strife, become a Christian and thy loving wife. So Jessica speaks a soliloquy. She says, O God, what a heinous sinner I am, being ashamed to be my father's child, but I need to remember I'm related to him by blood and not behavior. And then she thinks about Lorenzo and saying to Lorenzo, she says, O Lorenzo, if you keep your promise to me, I'll end this agony by becoming a Christian and marrying you. And then she exits. So this was with regard to Act 2, Scene 3. Now we move on to Act 2, Scene 4, where Graciano, Lorenzo, Slerino, and Salerno are present in Venice. Lorenzo says, nay, we will slink away in supper time, disguise us at my lodging, and return all in an hour. So as I told you, children, that Lorenzo is in love with Shylock's daughter, Jessica. Jessica and Shylock being Jew, of course, Shylock would never agree to marry Jessica with Lorenzo, who is a Christian. So Lorenzo is making a plan with his friends to elope with Jessica. So he says, during the feast time when Bassanio will be feasting with his friends, at that time we are going to slink away in the supper time. So Lorenzo speaks this. He says, we will sneak away at supper time, disguise ourselves with the masks at my house, and come back in an hour. To which Graciano says, we have not made good preparation. Graciano says, but we haven't made any preparations for the same. Slerino says, we have not spoke us yet of torchbearers. So if we have to have a mask, we have to have people disguised in and walking in a procession, we need to have the torchbearers as well. So Graciano and Slerino are saying that we have not spoken us yet of the torchbearers as well. We haven't even talked about who the torchbearers are going to be. Salerno says it's this while, unless it may be quaintly ordered and better in my mind not undertook. So Salerno says the masquerade party might turn out terribly if we don't manage that particular thing carefully. I think it's better to call it off. So Lorenzo says, 'tis now but 4 o'clock. We have 2 hours to furnish us. Lorenzo speaks, it's only 4 o'clock now and we have 2 hours to get ready for that masquerade. Enter Lancelot with a letter. Lancelot enters with a letter. Lancelot's friend Lancelot, what's the news? So he's asked by Lorenzo as to what the news is, what's going on. Lancelot replies, he gives a letter to Lorenzo and says, and it shall please you to break up this, it shall seem to signify. Lancelot says, when he gives the letter to Lorenzo, he says, if you don't mind opening this letter, you can find it for yourself. Lorenzo says, I know the hand in faith, its fair hand and whiter than the paper it writ on is the fair hand that writ. So Lorenzo is able to recognize the letter with the handwriting. He says, I recognize the handwriting, it is beautiful handwriting, and the beautiful hand that wrote the letter is whiter than the paper it is written on. Graciano says, love news in faith. Graciano asks Lorenzo, I bet it's a love letter, I believe it's a love letter. To which Lancelot replies to Lorenzo, by your leave, sir, I must take your permission if I may be excused to go, sir. To which Lorenzo says, whither goest thou? Means, where are you going?
Lancelot says, "Merry sir, to bid my old master, the Jew, to sup tonight with my new master, the Christian." So Lancelot replies, "To invite my former boss, the Jew, that is Shylock, to dine tonight with my new master, the Christian, that is Bassanio." Lorenzo, giving Lancelot some money, he says, "Hold here, take this, tell gentle Jessica, I'll not fail her, speak it privately. Go, gentlemen, will you prepare you for this mask tonight? I'm provided of a torchbearer." So Lorenzo says, he gives this letter money to Lancelot. He says, "Hold on, take this money and take this letter and tell Jessica, I won't fail her. Tell her in private, go, gentlemen, get ready for the masquerade tonight." Then he looks at the other gentlemen who are present there. He asks them to get ready for the masquerade. "I have someone who can be my torchbearer." So he's already thought of a torchbearer for himself, and he believes Jessica will be his torchbearer. Exit Lancelot the clown. Lancelot exits the scene. Slarino says, "Hey, Mary, I will be gone about it straight." "All right, I will go get things ready," he says. Slarino says, "And so will I." And he says, "Me too." Lorenzo says, "Me too. Meet me and Graciano at Graciano's lodging some hour hence." So Lorenzo instructs his friends that they shall meet him at Graciano's house in about an hour. Slarino says, "It's good we do so. It is good we were doing this." Excellent Slarino and Salenio. Graciano says, "Was not that letter from fair Jessica?" So he asked Lorenzo, "Wasn't that letter from Jessica?" To which Lorenzo replies, he says, "I must need thee tell all she had directed how I shall take her from her father's house, what golden jewels she is going to be furnished with." So Lorenzo says, "I have to tell you everything, Graciano, that she has told me how I can get her out of her father's house. She has also told me what gold and jewelry she owns, and she is described the page's uniform she is going to wear, what page's suit she hath in readiness. She is even described as to what servant suit will she be disguised in. If ever the Jew her father come to heaven, it will be for his gentle daughter's sake, and never dare misfortune cross her foot." So he says that if her father ever would come to heaven, it will be only because of Jessica, the fair Jessica, the deeds of Jessica that she has done, that her father will get a place in heaven. Otherwise, he has no chances of going to heaven. And he will never dare misfortune cross her feet unless she do it under this excuse. Now, he talks about Jessica, that Jessica will not ever have misfortune crossing her feet unless there is only one reason. There can only be one viable reason for why Jessica will have to face misfortune, and that will be that she is the issue to a faithless Jew, that she is the daughter of an unbelieving Jew, Shylock. He says that if Jessica ever has to be debarred from going to heaven, it will only because of her father. Then he gives Graciano the letter. "Pursue this as thou goest. Fair Jessica shall be my torchbearer." Then he gives that letter to Graciano. "You can look at this letter over as you go. Beautiful Jessica will be my torchbearer." So children, with this we come to the end of Act 2, Scene 4. I am going to attach 3 questions with this particular video. I would expect you to go through these 3 questions and attempt them in your fair literature and English notebooks. Till then, goodbye. Thank you so much. Have a nice day, and God bless you all.